House for that purpose. He was a very kind man. He was humble, and he didn't ask for a salary for this job.
Right.
And after his death, it was revealed that he donated this house for the state of Israel. All the objects inside the house, and those we can see over 1,200 books written in 6 different languages that Chaim Weizmann spoke. Chaim Weizmann also was what we call a serial writer, because you know, back then we didn't have Facebook, emails, or WhatsApp, or other magical stuff like that. So he used those 6 languages to communicate with different Jewish communities around the world, and also some other politicians, like from the British. They signed this agreement. The name of the agreement is Weizmann FISA. And Chaim Weizmann was also the first one that suggested to divide Israel into 2 countries, to a Jewish country and another country, but the Arabs refused it.
Yes, yes.
Very unfortunate.
Yeah, very unfortunate. She also died in this room, you think?
No, Vera, she died in England. She had a house there too.
But this is like an apartment here.
Said that he was a very simple Jew from Otto, and he wants to be remembered this way, it's this way.